match against Haumain, where they played to a goalless draw, and he is out of the tie today. A lot of pressure then for Lloyd Mutasa. No doubt a lot was expected from FC Platinum coming into this season. So it hasn't gone according to plan, one would say, with just 3 wins so far this season in 12 matches. It's FC Platinum and Bantu Rovers here. The man in the center, Rugare Kusosa, will be in charge of this match, assisted by Parera Chira, as well as the fourth official, who is Mnyarazi Majoni. The two captains are then Kamusoko for FC Platinum and Mavizita Masugu for Bantu Rovers, just going for the toss. A bit chilly then here in Zishawane, as we see the fans just trying to keep themselves warm here. FC Platinum then making that change where Beremo is out of the team. Then the twin center backs will be James Marufu alongside Katebe as the twin center backs. Also, Bello comes in to play the right back position. Out is Shoko. Up front, Maziwisa and Rukanda will be spearheading the attacker, as Walter Musona will also be in that team. On the other end, for Bantu Rovers, they've dropped Lawson Komo, is still injured. In comes Bongani Sikwili to play the right back position. Still up front, Tafaza Coutinho will be there alongside Obadiah Tarumba. Eberton Chuma maintains his number as a left back. Bukosi Sibanda also comes in ahead of Moses Machiga, who is out of the team. Sibanda, the 17-year-old, has scored in the last two matches. Sitting tight on the bench, then Shoko, who has enjoyed the right back position. Also on the bench is Kahadzikwa, as well as Katsairo is out there on the bench. Out of the team is Donald Ngoma, injured. And for Bantu Rovers, a surprise that Zephaniah Ngozo is on the bench alongside Cesar Lobutle Dube, the veterans. Metembe Ndlovu then, the club president and head coach of Bantu Rovers. Well, Bantu Rovers, they come into this match having actually recorded more wins than FC Platinum, and that should give them a little bit of confidence coming into this match, Bantu Rovers. But they have not won away from home, and FC Platinum on the other hand yet as well be consistent. They have lost once yet, one before to Wange, and they would want to improve on their record right here. So Bantu Rovers in red and FC Platinum in mainly white with patches of green and white, if you may want to put it that way. We'll see how it goes then here at Mandava Stadium. So Tarumba will be with Coutinho up front, as there is need to attend to the goal poster, as it will give a bit of a challenge then. So quite an interesting starting 11 for Bantu Rovers, where the twin center backs also out is a veteran Zephaniah Ngozo. In comes a teenage Katebe to be in a part of that team. Lawson Komo start on the bench then for Bantu Rovers. He is yet to fully recover from his injury that kept him out of the team for quite some time. Not a huge crowd then that has come to witness this tie here at Mandava Stadium, but still a few fans coming to witness this tie here at Mandava Stadium. That's the man in charge, Rugare Kusosa. He will ensure that the laws of the game are followed here at Mandava Stadium, and Bantu Rovers will get us underway here, playing in red, playing from left to right, as they lose a position very early, and a shot coming through, and that one just going out for a goal kick. Nelson Maziwisa, who hasn't been featuring for FC Platinum, although he started in that goalless draw against Haumain, has that restart for FC Platinum, and he would want to grab that opportunity with a fine performance then here at Mandava Stadium. Chakunda Mutanga, the Bantu Rovers goalkeeper, will be dispatching the goal kick. One of the young players then featuring in the Bantu Rovers team, Mutanga, only aged 23 years, but they have a 17-year-old as well in this team, and already with two goals this season. And the two goals are coming in the last 2 weeks. Vukosi Sivanda. Emberton Chuma, the left back, with the throw-in this time for Bantu Rovers. Cleared out again by FC Platinum. Sikwili trying to get onto that one. Zireni Beck once more in the Bantu Rovers set up, having missed the Caps United match. Mudewe. That's a blind pass for Bantu. Tandazani Ndlovu will try to collect the pieces. He was here a couple of seasons back at FC Platinum. Tandazani Ndlovu, not the best of the runs then at FC Platinum, and now in Bantu Rovers colors. Tarumba cleared out again by FC Platinum. Langeni playing the anchoring role for Bantu Rovers as FC Platinum clear that one out. It's an interesting clash here. Two teams that also like to pass the ball around, but at times a failure in terms of the finishing, as Mazuisa was fouled on that occasion by Sikwili. The free kick going in favor of Bantu Rovers. Pride Zereni is going to take the free kick. He's already on three goals this season. A good run for a defender as he comes up with the long one. That is cleared away by FC Platinum. So lots of changes in the Platinum team from the team that we have been seeing when the season started. No Jabulo Ncube in the team. The rumors are growing strong that he might be finding his way back to Highlanders. The FC Platinum striker Ndlovu now collects for Bantu as they try to knock it. Sikwili will try to get into the box as he comes up with a cross. That one goes straight to Petros Muhari. And he quickly releases right back Bello. Quite interesting that FC Platinum have opted for Bello to be the right back, as they break with an opportunity that is headed out by Pride Zereni for a throw-in on the left side. There was the cross there, and Pride Zereni did well to clear that one out of danger, but still winning possession. Bantu Rovers as they clear it out now with Vukosi Sibanda. Go. Wide to the right now, where there is Sikwili. Katebe with the clearance, controlled well by Mobizita Masubu. I mean, with the clearance for FC Platinum, as it goes out for a throw-in to Bantu Rovers. They have tried to be involved in FC Platinum's half in the opening 5 minutes. Bantu Rovers, Tarumba. A bit of confidence then in Obadiah Tarumba after he grabbed a press in Bantu Rovers' last match, that 3-1 victory of Buffaloes at Luveva Stadium. Good play this time by Coutinho. Over Tarumba with the touch that is cleared out again by FC Platinum as they try to pick up Marshall Mundewe on the left side. Cleared out again by Claude Zereni for Bantu Rovers. a foul now to FC Platinum.
Ade, sorry, Ade, Ade, Ade.
Zereni with time to clear for Bantu Rovers as he puts it out of touch for a throw-in. Proud Zereni, the Bantu Rovers defender. He enjoys as well playing as a defensive midfielder, at times used as an attacking midfielder, but this time around being used as a centre-back. Just confirming his utility for Bantu Rovers. Katebe now in a bit of a miss there as of course this one that tries to win that one. The referee says it had gone out. He will want 3 points in what will be the first maximum point for Bantu Rovers away from home as Bongani Sikwili takes the throw in. Tarumba. Tarumba trying to come with a backheel. It's forced out for a throw-in by FC Platinum. Obadiah Tarumba. Coutinho. The cross is not a good one then from Coutinho as it goes out of touch for a goal kick to FC Platinum. Petros Mohari will be trying to keep a clean sheet for his team here. They found it difficult to come up with these clean sheets, FC Platinum, this season. Just three so far, and maybe I can expand to Rovers, they will fancy their chances. Masugu clears that one out. He's off in midfield, finding his captain, Mavizita Masugu. Still, Masugu regains possession for Bantu. Well, Kusosa involved a bit there as the Platinum try to break away. The cross will come through inside the box there. And Takunda Mutanga collects for Bantu Rovers. He has taken over the number one jersey at Bantu Rovers. As Katebe clears. Still Bantu Tarumba with the cross. There is an offside on the far side, says Parewa, the first official, first assistant referee, saying it's an offside as Tarumba tried to come up with the cross for Bantu Rovers. He had done well. Kadi Amin with the free kick this time for FC Platinum. Sikwili first on the ball to push it out for a throw-in. Inside the opening, Scala. 10 minutes and no goal then to talk about. But lots of talking from the two coaches as they try to be on top of this match here. Sikwili. Gamsoko. Bello with the clearance. It's a push out again by Bantu Rovers as this time they push it back to goalkeeper Muhari. Katebe collects once more. Well, he has not been featuring as well for FC Platinum, but Oflet has been coming in as a substitute, and this afternoon he starts in that central defense role for FC Platinum as Chuma tries to collect. He has done well. Emberton comes up with the cross. Not the best of the crosses as FC Platinum pick Kamsoko, the captain. This time it's a wide on the right for Musona. The return to Musona, not precise. Zireni just putting his back to that ball, and Rugare Kusosa indicating that it's a free kick that goes the way of FC Platinum. He just put his back there to that action, proud as Zireni, and the referee awarding the free kick to FC Platinum.
So that's not going to
Goalkeeper Mutanga has asked for a four-man wall, which Bantu have put up. Kamusoko is behind that one now for FC Platinum. Perhaps an opportunity here if they can just try to curl it around the wall and maybe around the goalkeeper for an opening here. It's a low one. It's against the wall. The touch goes straight to Mutanga. He'll be happy. That is a four-man wall. Did well to defend that free kick. Coutinho with a long-range speculative shot. That goes wide. No trouble then for Petros Muhari, the FC Platinum goalkeeper. That's a good one now as FC Platinum try to be dominant in this match here, where Bantu have given them little space at least so far, as Ndlovu now comes up with the clearance. Coutinho, he picks his captain Masugu. Everton will find it difficult to keep that one in play. He has done so, but the touch is not good enough as Masugu, captain, picks yet another loose ball in midfield. So that has been the feature then happening for Bantu Rovers. The captain Masugu picking up those loose balls, but this time Rukanda will try to create something for FC Platinum as he releases Kadi. I mean, he comes up with a cross there. Oh, it's off target on that occasion from Mazisa. Kadi, I mean, always coming up with these fine crosses. The header then, he tried to at least turn so that he directs it into the goal of the Mazisa, but it was not to be. One of the top strikers in the last couple of seasons then here in the local Premier League, but yet to find his footing right here at FC Platinum. Maybe now this will be the chance for him to shine with the remote, with the reported move away from FC Platinum or from Jabu Dongo. Coutinho fouled just by the center circle. James Marufu, the man who committed that foul on Coutinho, the tackle there, the referee Kusosa awarding the free kick then to Bantu Rovers. A very tricky ball it was from Coutinho. As Zireni once more behind the free kick for Bantu Rovers. Just monitoring the situation is Petros Muhari, as now Zireni chips it into the box, and that one is safely collected by Muhari. FC Platinum lose that one for a throw-in then to Bantu Rovers. Emberton Chuma behind the throw-in. Emberton Chuma once more. The clearance is good from FC Platinum. Still want to knock it around in midfield as Masugu collects now, picking Emberton Chuma. So Bantu have enjoyed it positionally here. And it's cleared out again by James Marufu for FC Platinum. Bit of an open foot then from Nelson Mazuisa. It's a free kick which goes to Bantu Rovers. Proud Zereni was going for the clearance and an open foot then from Nelson Mazwisa. Free kick to Bantu Rovers with 16 minutes gone here at Mandava Stadium. Concerns then about the second ball from Mete Bendovo. Proud Zereni. It's headed out by FC Platinum. Chuma will collect once more for Bantu. Coutinho. Still Coutinho. Sipini. Tarumba. A grounder then coming from Tarumba. Not to trouble the goalkeeper. Petros Mohari didn't have much power in it. Sikwili will head it back this time to goalkeeper Mutanga. Kadi Amin. Cleared out again by Sikwili. The flick now from Coutinho. And that one just rolling out for a throw-in to Bantu Rovers. Sipini fighting for that one. The flag is up. And no much threat then for FC Platinum at that stage. It was for rough play then by Sipini on Kadi Amin. Kadi Amin was fouled on that occasion to end the free kick for FC Platinum. A tackle from FC Platinum will give them a possession and maybe an opportunity to try and create something, as now Bello breaks on the right side. He comes up with the long cross. The header is coming through. That one should be an easy one for the goalkeeper, Takuna. Mohari with the clearance for FC Platinum. Amin. A good tackle then from Mutasa, just to save the situation for FC Platinum as Bantu are trying to break away. Katebe. Mutasa. Free kick to FC Platinum as Mutasa went for that ball. He was fouled in the process. Katebe with the free kick then for FC Platinum. I mean, back again to Katebe. Cleared out again by Sikwini. Gift Bello will try to break away. He is a foul. He is playing on the right side of the defense this afternoon. There was Bello in a tussle then with the Master Mlangeni. I mean, controlled by Coutinho to pick and Jovo. Jovo has done well with his left foot passing in midfield for Bantu Rovers. FC Platinum in possession this time as they break on right. The cross comes through then inside the box. Still with a chance. FC Platinum trying to force their way. Kadi Amin with a shot. It's off target this time from the left to back of FC Platinum, who has done well this season to be on 4 goals. But on that occasion, that one just going wide from the left back. Takunda Mutanga this time with a goal kick for Bantu Rovers. It's a clear out by Zireni. Doing very well in defense, Zireni. Zavikosi tries to break inside the box and then is cleared out by FC Platinum. As FC Platinum played it dangerously at the back. And Bantu Rovers winning most of the tackles, winning most of the free kicks as well here. Zireni will try to initiate a move then here for Bantu Rovers inside the opening 22 minutes of the first half here at Mandava Stadium. No goals to talk about. Some pushing then inside the box from Obadiah Taruba against James Marufu. Marufu will get the free kick on that occasion, says the referee. Lots of pushing and pulling as well. And the referee quite right to award the free kick to FC Platinum. Masu pumped forward by Bantu Rovers, straight to goalkeeper Petros Muhari. He edges, he is a man to move forward. They haven't really had clear-cut opportunities. Bantu Rovers seem to be first on the ball against FC Platinum at this stage as Sikwidi comes up with a long clearance. Another of the long clearance, this time as it goes out on the far side from Gift Bello, maybe explaining the unfamiliar right back position that he's playing at FC Platinum this afternoon. This time Katebe pushes it out for a throw-in. And Coutinho can't beat the two men of FC Platinum, but still Bantu are fighting for possession here with Taruba. Katebe is trying to fight for that one, and this time they will play it out. FC Platinum, and just putting his boot there was Mavisita Masugu, just to tidy things for Bantu Rovers. They have really tried to be first on the ball in this first half. Coutinho. Marufu with the clearance. Kamsoko. Mudewe collects this time for FC Platinum. Still Mudewe. And Sikwidi will collect the pieces. Amin has done beautifully to keep that one in play as he tries to come with the long one. It was almost going out and they did well to just keep it in play. Looks like Lloyd Mutasa is worried about the communication aspect of his team. That's the point he is stressing on that occasion, saying let's communicate. Marufu. Bello. Back again to Marufu. Through this time for Mudewe. He beats his man keenly, but not for the second time, although they will get the free kick on the far side. He had done well to beat Chuma. And Chuma winning that one through rough play, and it's a free kick to give to Bello and the FC Platinum. Header coming through. There is a passing kick then inside the box from Nelson Mazwisa. Yet to open his account in terms of goal scoring for the season, but with more opportunities in terms of starting coming up like this, no doubt his abilities are going to be confirmed with a couple of goals, I'm sure. Nelson Mazwisi did well when he was at Shabani Mine, and now two Shabani Mine strikers leading the FC Platinum strike force alongside Tarisa Irukanda. Mudewe next now on the right side, and cross comes inside the box. This could be a chance, then somehow it's blocked as Zerani clears that one. Good effort then for FC Platinum just inside the box to try and get a goal on that occasion, but proud Zereni working hard in defense as this time they come up with a throw-in. It's a long one as well inside the box. It's cleared out. Yes, Kamsoko. Maybe Amin with a shot. It's blocked out again by Bantu Rovers. And this time they'll clear the pieces just to make sure at the back. But quite a good attack then from FC Platinum. Yes, Kamsoko. Mutasa in midfield. He was put back. And Gusosa did support that. There was that effort coming through. A lovely cross then inside the box. Good turn as well to try and shoot using his left. Tarisa Irukanda, about the proud Zereni did well to block, there. And there was that impediment from behind by captain Mwabizita Masugu, earning a yellow card. So Masugu getting the first yellow of this match here. Just monitoring his defense and watching the ball closely as Amin prepares to take the free kick. He chips it well ahead, coming through, and that one collected by the goalkeeper Takunda Mutanga. A fine free kick it was. It didn't have power though, and the header just coming through for Mutanga to make the fine save. So despite the position seemingly in favor of Bantu, Platinum have had no shot at goal, as that one will go straight to the goalkeeper, Takunda Mutanga. Of course, clearance is not precise then from FC Platinum, as this time Chandasani Jov collects on the left. The cross comes through and it's out. No danger then for Petros Muhari, and FC Platinum, it gives them an opportunity just to create another build up from the back. No danger there from Chandasani Jov, a player who's been at FC Platinum before. To the right where there is Marufu. Sikwili with the clearance. Katebe with another long clearance to keep it out for a throw-in. Sikwili. Tarumba will spread it this time to the left side where there is Emberton Chuma. Good control, but been forced out of the penalty box at Abantu Rovers. But Chuma will try to come up with the cross. The flea comes through and it's headed out, but still with an opportunity. The shot is not good. It falls then from Langen inside the box. That one took a deflection. Mastam Langeni, no deflection. It's a goal kick. It was a miscue then, an opportunity for the men playing the defensive link. Continue to miss that one. Then Mulangeni, just inside the box, he actually shoot wide there with an opportunity. So possession slightly going back once more to Platinum in the last 5 minutes, and overall they've enjoyed. But Bantu come with a cross this time that is easily collected by Petros Mohari. chest control, not very good at that stage, and Bantu Rovers trying to create out of danger as they do so, but it won't be a problem for FC Platinum to start yet another attack. That's a fine move then from FC Platinum. Bello. Mukanda trying to use his shielding game. Back again into Kamusoko. And it's cleared out again by Everton Chuva. Tandazani Govu at the end of that one. Gift Bello with the throw-in then for FC Platinum just under 15 minutes before the end of the first 45 minutes as the cross comes through, and Masugu will clear that one out straight for yet another throw-in, still on the right side of FC Platinum's attack, as they would want to go for one of those long throw-ins. It's a long one indeed inside the box. This could be an opportunity. Then the shot comes through. Another fine serve from Takunda Mutanga. He has been coming up with these serves all season, at least in the matches that he has played. The 23-year-old goalkeeper, Takunda Mutanga. Fine flick, the shot comes through, a good diving from Mutanga just to push it out to keep Bantu Rovers in this match here. That one was a goal indeed. He did well to save that one. It's a three-man wall then for Bantu Rovers, as Platinum have been doing very well in the last few minutes. Mutanga again punches it out. He just does his goalkeeping basics very well, Takunda Mutanga, as he parried that one out. Always talented as a promising goalkeeper, Mutanga, but has not been getting the starting jersey at Bantu, and each time he has grabbed it, he has been doing very well. So far, he has kept his team in this match here, as they clear that one out of danger. Maruf with the clearance. It's been a good surge by FC Platinum in the last 5 minutes to try and get a goal in this match here, but Bantu Rovers holding their own at the back. Through ball this time for Bantu Rovers. That is cleared out by FC Platinum, and they'll get a free kick as well on the left side.
Drop some ambition. Right corner, right. Malele!
Kadi Amin with the free kick this time for FC Platinum. Rukanda shielding again, and he will try to position himself to push as Musona comes up with the cross. It's cleared out again by Bantu Rovers. This is a good spell then from FC Platinum as Bello comes up with the cross. The header comes through just wide from Rukanda, the striker. He has kept Bantu in this match. Mutanga with that fine save, and another cross that he just carried out. Options then look good for FC Platinum. Gahadzikwa in there as well, a player that they can call upon to try and change the game. Steven Sibanda, a top goal scorer at Buffalo's last season. Chuma for Bantu Rovers. Hanging offense by the 17-year-old Wukosi Sibanda. Just hangled outside the box. Kamsoko in midfield this time for Bantu. Masugu will collect. as he picks Tanzani Dog. Platinum too well to try and clear the pieces through Kati Amin. Masuisa was trying to switch it to the right side, but he gets a return, and now he opts still for the right side, which Everton Chuma has done well to clear. Trying to pick Mudewe is what Masuisa was trying. We haven't seen those amazing runs from Mudewe in this match, but here he comes, maybe just to prove us wrong here. And it's cleared out again by Bantu Rovers. Tarumba. Visitor Masugu, the captain, through ball this time for Tarumba. Yes, downward, he comes up with a shot, and that one just goes over the bar. A bit of intelligent play then inside the box. The bench can't believe it. Tarumba can't believe it. He wanted it just by the back of the net, but it was not to be. The passing was brilliant. Tarumba, the touch, oh, brilliant. Then the cross, the shot, just going over the bar. Brilliant play from Bantu, brilliant play from Tarumba, but no goal to talk about as Platinum break now again. There was Musona foul. It's actually Mutasa, the referee will play on. FC Platinum break again. And they were stopped by Emberton Kuma to pick Jofu. Tarumba. He seems to have regained his form, or maybe it was a question of match fitness on the part of Obadiah Tarumba. The Bantu Rovers striker, who has seen it all, has been to Belgium, has been to Cyprus, has been to Kenya, has been to South Africa, and back once more here in Zimbabwe. Obadiah Tarumba already with 3 goals for Bantu Rovers this season, a press last weekend against Buffalo at Kuzewa Stadium. Bantu Rovers are defending in numbers. Katebe then clearing that one out of danger. As the cross comes through, and Mutanga once more just collects that one. The whistle had gone anyway for an offside decision. The flag was up. So it will be a free kick now, but Mutanga did not want to wait for the whistle. He just wanted to collect it, and he did well on that occasion. A good first half from the young goalkeeper. Cleared out again by Kamsoko. FC Platinum with yet another clearance, this time Pride Zereni is fighting for possession, and it will be a throw-in. It comes again now with a cross then for FC Platinum. Katebe clears that one out of danger as it falls again on Coutinho with a through ball for Tarumba. He's onside, he gets into the box, he tries to shoot. It's a simple shot that is collected easily, punched out by Petros Muhari as he lies injured, Tarumba. But FC Platinum will try to break to get a goal for themselves, and Bantu Rovers will regain possession as Sibanda pushes out of touch so that Tarumba can be attended to, and just going as well to wish Tarumba well. A quick recovery is the goalkeeper, Petros Muhari. Another fine touch is then from Bantu Rovers. Did well to get into the box. The pass did not work for him, and the balance as well was not the best for Tarumba. He did well one touch. The second touch now was the shorter, and the balance was always an awkward one on that occasion, and the shorter saved by Petros Muhari. It was not a powerful shorter. It keeps this match at goalless with 5 minutes to halftime. Tarumba slowly going back to his best in the last few weeks, although he did miss a penalty at Rufaro Stadium against Harare City, but slowly coming back into his best is Obadiah Tarumba. Mutanga now the goalkeeper for Bantu Rovers. Sikwini. It's cleared out by Kadi Amin. And FC Platinum will get the goal. Petros Mahari with the goal kicker this time for FC Platinum. Keyed out by Sikwini. Mukosi Sibanda on the right side. He's been quiet in the first half. Jovu can't come with the pass. And Bello will break now to initiate an attack here for FC Platinum. Through ball, it's a good one as well for Mudewe. Kamsoko, can he shoot? He does so. It's not a good shot. It's blocked out by Bantu Rovers. Sikwili with the clearance. Cut, I mean, fouled, free kick to FC Platinum. That's the Bantu Rovers bench. There's that late tackle then from Jovu, fouling Kadi Amin. Flick it then to FC Platinum. And it's a good one as well in the box. The goalkeeper is not inside. There's a shot comes, and it's a goal again here for FC Platinum. Mudewe, as the goalkeeper moved out of his line to try and clear that one. It fell easily for Mudewe. And they obliged with the shot. He did well. The free kick once more from Kadi Amin. Cleared out by Zireni. And the shot comes in. A bit of poor communication then between Zireni and his goalkeeper. And capitalizing on that with the shot is Mudewe as FC Platinum take the lead here. Just before the break, chest control, and then the shot comes through. Tatenda Marshall Mudewe with the goal then for FC Platinum. And just before the break here, it looks like Tarumba could not continue with the play following that effort, so you are still out of the pitch as FC Platinum managed to capitalize and get that goal. So in the first half here, Platinum 1, Bantu Rovers 0. And this will give Platinum all the confidence. Coutinho. He has picked Mukosi on the far side. He's in an offside position. Flick it then to FC Platinum, who are leading this one here by 1-0. Now the flick comes through for Mudewe. He has done well, still Mudewe. That will give him lots of confidence. Inside the box then comes Soko, trying to come with a shot, but too many red jerseys around him as Bantu Rovers clear that one out. And Rukanda came with a tackle. It's a free kick. To Bantu Rovers, and Takunda Mutanga, the goalkeeper behind the goal kick, the free kick. We'll play just a minute of additional time here as Bantu try to snatch an equalizer, but it's cleared out by FC Platinum, and they try to break as well on the right side through Mudewe. And they can't connect just outside the box, and this time the substitute, Lawson Gomo, will clear it out. Kadi Amin preparing to take the throw in. Amin with the long one. Zireni clears that one out of danger. Free kick to Bantu Rovers, and proud Zireni is behind the free kick as Rugare Gusosa plays close to end the first 45 minutes here at Mandava Stadium, and Marshall Mudewe with the goal then for FC Platinum to give them a 1-0 lead at halftime. It was a tight contest in the first half, but Bantu Rovers concede where they have not won or picked a point away from home. A good one then for FC Platinum, would want to pick maximum point here. The halftime score then here at Mandava Stadium in Zishawane, it's FC Platinum 1, Bantu Rovers 0. Half-time then here at Mandava Stadium, the scoreline was 1-0 and the second half just about to resume here. And quite interesting that we have seen just one yellow card then going to Bantu Rovers captain, and the 12 fouls committed by Bantu Rovers, and just one goal to talk about, that one coming through from Marshall Mudewe, and an injury as well in the first half, forcing Obadiah Taruba, who was doing very well at that stage, to be substituted, and Bray Chiro is going to come in for Otarisai Irukanda for FC Platinum. New options then up front for FC Platinum. It's a striker for a striker. Bantu Rovers earlier on making a change, taking out a striker for a defender as Obadiah Taruba picked an injury. FC Platinum will get us underway for the second half. Mudewe was trying to go for that one. Chuma with the throw-in. Zireni with the clearance. Musona collects this time for FC Platinum as he tries to create something. A shot coming through then from the substitute of Bray Chiro. Bantu Rovers are trying to collect the pieces in midfield, and they will lose it this time as FC Platinum break away. Through ball then, this time with an opportunity. Zireni with the clearance for Bantu Rovers. Kadi Amini prepares to take the throw-in. Gomo with the clearance. So with Lawson Gomo coming in just before the halftime whistle, he will occupy the right back position, and it will mean that Sikwini drops into midfield to be alongside Mulangeni. He will play the anchoring role with Mulangeni just in front of him. Here is now Mudewe, then for FC Platinum. A shot comes through, and another one just going over the bar from Bray Chiro. On the other end of the FC Platinum changer, it's a striker. So it's just a question of trying new options in terms of getting the goals for Lloyd Mutasa and FC Platinum. Mutanga now with the goal kick. Gamsoko. Jovu. Headed out again by FC Platinum. Bukosi Sivani. And that one will go straight again to goalkeeper Petros Muhari. Good ball this time again for Mudewe. He drives on those on the cross, comes through. Fine goalkeeping from Takunda Mutanga. Good run from Mudewe. Good cross. Good goalkeeping. It remains 1-0 to FC Platinum. Kamsoko. Amin. A tackle coming through. Squeely. Masugu. Zireni with the clearance. Cleared out again by Zireni. Through ball this time they try to dig Mutasa, and Sireni has the duty of clearing that one out of danger for Bantu Rovers. Wisdom Mutasa being coached here by his father. But how the instructions go on the pitch there, father and son, as it comes now again to FC Platinum trying to create an opportunity. FC Platinum will now defend with Katebe. It's headed out again by FC Platinum. Zireni with the clearance. Chira is fouled just by the center circle, and it's a free kick. Good ball control, and he kept it in possession very well until he was fouled. I mean, we'll collect now. Here is Mutasa with a good touch, then good steal, although he finds it difficult against Ngoma, who clears that one out of danger for Bantu Rovers. Vukosi Sibanda. Through ball this time for Emberton Chuma. He tries to roll it to Vukosi. The pass is not precise, but still Chuma fighting for possession. He is fouled. He will get a free kick then for Bantu Rovers. He was fighting to find his way through. Emberton Chuma and fouled. He gets a free kick then for Bantu Rovers, as they've committed 7 fouls for FC Platinum. And Ngomo loves to come up with beautiful crosses from these positions. Came as a substitute just before the half-time whistle. Some pushing and shoving then in the box, and the referee will have to just have a word or two with the players concerned. Gombo was coming up with the free kick, and Rugari Kusosa just indicating as well where the foul should be taken. Lawson Gombo. There is a two-man wall defense for FC Platinum as Ngomo comes up with a free kick. It's a good one as well, and that one is just out. No danger then for FC Platinum. A dangerous cross it was from Lawson Ngomo. One of his specialty, and the goalkeeper did well. Fighting well. Although Coutinho could have done a lot better, but poor marking as well in a defense there for FC Platinum, as they need to protect their 1-0 lead here to pick the maximum point. The fans here trying to keep themselves warm here at Mandava Stadium in Zishabane, where FC Platinum are leading this one by 1-0, with the Bantu Rovers getting a free kick wide on the right. Mohari just monitoring that one, as Zireni will prepare to take the free kick. He gets a return from that blocked free kick to Ngoma. Ngoma tries to cut through. He gets in the box. Perhaps holding on to the ball for too long. And this time, Bantu Rovers will clear the pieces out of danger. Kamsoko collects just by the center circle. Maruf. Mudewe with a touch trying to pick Chira. Emerton Chuma just forcing that one out of touch. Emerton Chuma will be taking the throw. Coutinho with the touch as that one goes out for a throw-in. Yes. Gift Velo with the throw-in. Still, they will get another throw-in. FC Platinum as they try to stage ahead to get throw in and create an opportunity to try and get a win from this match here. Masu, cleared out by Chuma. Coutinho collects. Still Coutinho. Tackle coming through, that one going out. No foul. It will be a throw in at Bantu Rovers. Chuma is behind the throw-in. Tandazani Ndlovu has committed another foul on the right side, and Bello will leave it for James Marufu. Katebe to Amin. The clearance is out. Pride Zireni with the free kick then for Bantu Rovers. Marufu with the clearance. A big season then for James Marufu in the heart of the FC Platinum defense. Is done well to maintain that position. Alan Kazikwa maybe might be coming in as it remains 1-0. Long throw in inside the box then for Bantu Rovers. The flick is on. Good clearance by Mutasa. Hadele tries to pump it into the box, and Muhari will rest out of his goal area to push that one out of danger for a throw-in. Last minute instructions then for Katikwa as the long throw-in comes for Bantu. Gomo. The cross is not precise. It's cleared out of danger by FC Platinum as Chirwa does well to release Mudewe. Mudewe now will try to break. He picks Mutasa. And the pass not one of the finest men from Wisdom Mutasa. And Mutanga will collect that one. Mudewe did well to release Wisdom Sibanda. He tried to chip it, probably thinking that Mudewe has gone in for that particular one, has made a run. Some defensive work have to be done now as Bantu Rovers get a free kick. So that's the substitution then. Alan Kazikwa coming in, and off goes Wisdom Mutasa. He will get a check from his father. Out this time by Katebe. Throw in Adana to Bantu Rovers. It's actually an FC Platinum Pro win. It's cleared out again by Katebe in defense for Bantu. Cleared out again by FC Platinum. Masu. Coutinho. And it's a push out again for a throw-in. Proud Zereni for Bantu Rovers, the cross inside the box. And that one just crushing the crossbar as it goes out. A free header then for Tandazani Ndovu. The cross from Zereni and the header. And that one just brushing the crossbar. Good crosser from Zereni. Fine header, but couldn't beat the crossbar. So those patient build-ups from Bantu Rovers, they'll be hoping will give them something as Nkomo picks Sibanda. Back again to Nkomo. Trying to pick Coutinho on the far side. It's still Coutinho. He has done well to just sneak that ball between two defenders, but Amin recovers now for FC Platinum. And Bantu will clear that one out of danger. Leon says the referee, and the Platinum will break now inside the box. Chiro's trying to chip it over. Defensive work is cleared off the line. That one was number two then for FC Platinum, but it was cleared off the line. And that's a free kick now again to Bantu Rovers. The substitute Chiram, the ball came through. He did well to chip it over. The goalkeeper was racing, disturbed by Chuma. And then Katebe with a clearance just off the line for Bantu Rovers. And that one just cleared out. Good play from Chiro here to try and get the second one. And the clearance emphatic on that occasion by the center back. It remains 1-0 here at Mandava Stadium in Zishabane. As now Michel Katswairo, who has been starting for most of the games here, prepares to come in. He's on two goals this season, and they are taking out Walter Musona. That's the substitution. So two of the finest youngsters so far this season, Musona and Mutasa, go out as Katairo comes to occupy that attacking position on the right side of the midfield. The substitute Katsikwa fighting for position. Gift Bello with the throw-in for FC Platinum. Coutinho. Katsikwa winning that one for FC. That was a good ball, read well by Nkomo. And the clearance is good. Bantu Rovers are still enjoying, at least in the last 5 minutes, but overall it's FC Platinum who have a slight edge in terms of ball possession. Here is Bukosi Sibanda. He wanted to push it back to Nkomo, but FC defend very well, as this time Emberton Chuma will clear that one out of danger. Katairo. Another clearance coming through from the center back to push it out for a throw. Gift Bello. interesting occupying the right back position, and the cross comes through. Crowd already clears that one out of danger. Marufu. Chest control this time by Mavizi Tamasugo. Emberton Chuma. Another of the long clearances from FC Platinum, and Bantu Rovers will just try to tidy things as they control it in midfield with Bukosi. And the 17-year-old fouled by James Marufu alongside Gatairo. And the late tackle as well to get the free kick. Then a proud Zireni behind it for Bantu Rovers. Goal kick out. Proud Zireni had dispatched the free kick. Well, a youngster being brought as well to the stadium just to try appreciating it in the early years of the local football there. A free kick this time to Bantu Rovers. Emberton Chuma will leave that one. There was the foul then on Emberton Chuma by Katairo. He was always holding Emberton Chuma on that occasion. And Proud Zireni has been behind most of these free kicks for Bantu. He will have one or two words with his bench as he prepares to take the free kick. Still a danger for FC Platinum. They kick it up because it's over the bar from the Bantu Rovers midfielder. He has scored in the last two matches for Bantu. And on that occasion, his effort just going way over the bar. FC Platinum have maintained their first half lead at least up to this stage here, as another long ball comes through, but Bantu Rovers will have some work to do to defend because he collects once more. Katebe continue with the last touch, which goes out for a throw-in to
goal side. Let's be goal side, Aubrey. Goal side.
Throwing to Kadi Amin and FC Platinum. He clears that one out of, as there was a challenge from Coutinho. Still 1-0 to FC Platinum. And he looks a worried man, the Bantu Rovers assistant coach, Manjampo. It out this time by FC Platinum. Kadi Amin prepares to take the free kick. Coming into this match, FC Platinum had not recorded a win in their last three matches. Although they will argue and say that they were actually unbeaten as they were recording draws. So they are actually on a four-match unbeaten run. Before that, they have beaten Triangle by 4-0. Still FC Platinum forcing their way through. The shot will come, is blocked and is cleared out by Mavisi Tamasugu. So the three draws were against Haumain Goles in Bulawayo. Then a drew at home here with Black Rhinos. and threw away at Babakul Stadium with Islanders. There was that clash there between Marufu and Tandazani Ndlovu. And Tandazani Ndlovu has been booked by referee Rugari Musosa. So yellow card, it is Tandazani Ndlovu. He was here at FC Platinum just a few years back. Now turning out for Bantu Rovers as captain Kamsoko tries a long range one that just goes wide from the captain. So FC Platinum would want to maintain this. They would want to get a win. They would want to avoid conceding here in what will only be their fourth time they have failed to concede. They've managed to concede in four in 12 matches. Yes, Mudewe now. Can he come up with a shot? Does so. And that one just going wide from Marshall Mudewe. He's trying those long-range efforts, and the crowd also appreciating those efforts from Marshall Mudewe. And that one just going on. The scorer of the only goal that is separating the two teams here in what was his goal number one of the season, Marshall Tatenda Mutele. It's a clear out again by teenage Katebe, but Katebe will collect, being forced to pull it back to Bello. Through ball for Bello, and the tackle will come through for Masukini. Some fine passing then from Gifty Bello as FC Platinum. We're hoping to release Katairo on that occasion, but they'll be happy with the corner kick here. And their fans wanting a second goal. I mean, a dead ball specialist with the corner kick. And Bantu will clear that one out. Katikwa. And he has lost possession. It's cleared out by Proud Zereni. Oh, poor communication. It will fall on Coutinho. And Marufu this time will save the situation.
Alan!
Marufu and Mohari in poor communication and failing to punish them was Tandazani Ndlovu. Although initially Katikwa had lost possession in midfield. This is the first corner kick of the match of for Bantu Rovers after 73 minutes as they try to get the corner kick. It's a flighted well into the box. The header is missed by Zireni. Jovu will collect once more. Chuma cleared out again by FC Platinum. FC Platinum will push it wide for Katairo. He has kept it in play. He comes up with the cross. The header there, just missed that one. It will fall on Amin. And that one just goes wide. Four goals this season. And he would have wanted to catch that one as well. Well, two of his goals have come through from the penalty spot. One straight from the corner kick. And the other one against Trent was from open play. Kadi Amin on that occasion just wide. Chira collects this time for FC Platinum. They really want to add a second goal in this match. Yes, Captain Kamsoko this time finding Katairo. And that one is missed. Well, quite interesting. If Katairo was intending to cross on that particular occasion, and that effort just going wide.
That's
Lloyd Mutasa would want to maintain the shape of his team, especially in defense at this stage. These are the crucial moments here. They need the 3 points, no doubt about it. And at the moment, they are losing by 1 goal to nil. And they concede a corner kick. And Lawson Gomo will go once more for the corner kick. Usually flights them very well, creates opportunities for his team. Lawson Gomo, the way he flights the corner kicks. Coutinho in there as well. And this time it's not the finest. It's yet another corner kick. The second consecutive corner kick for Bantu Rovers. Still not the best from Lawson Gomo. As that one is cleared out by FC Platinum. Bukosi Sibanda. Still Bukosi. Holding on to the ball, is taken away by FC Platinum. They will force him to push it out for a throw-in. No goal for him today, because his Simanda have been scored in the last two matches for Bantu Rovers. Kaatikwa will spread it to the left where there is Amin. With a through ball this time from Chingwa. He has kept it in play. The cross will come from Amin. Still lacking with an opportunity. Katairo inside the box. They've all missed it. And the Bantu Rovers will clear with Nkomo. Bantu Rovers just to survive that one. FC Platinum failing to make it number two with an opportunity. Katebe. Bello with the clearance for FC Platinum. The flick. Zireni will collect. And Zireni this time will lose it. As they will break now with Mazuisa. And first on the ball was a teenager Katebe to save and clear the situation then for Bantu Rovers. Amin. Cleared out again by the proud Zireni. This time it's picked again by Chirwa. Being forced deep into midfield. As they push it back this time for goalkeeper Muhari. There's a chance then for Bukosi. It's cleared out again by FC Platinum. They would want the maximum points. FC Platinum, can they just take the second one? And a bit of a poor ball then from Chira. Could have done maybe a lot better. Just to kill this game as a contest here and kill whatever fight. But it was not to be. Lloyd Mutasa saying, let's communicate to his boys as they prepare to take the corner kick here. Looking for a second goal. Chumaki is that one. Coutinho makes sure. But still, Amin will collect this time for FC Platinum. Katairo with a fine pass, the flag is up. Although Takunda Mutanga had already collected that one. So Bantu Rovers just doing well to maintain their offside trap, but they'll still be not happy that they are trailing this match by 1-0. Katebe in defense has done well alongside James Marufu not to allow Bantu Rovers to score. Cleared out this time by FC Platinum, collected by Lawson. Come on. The free kick is quickly taken by FC Platinum with a through ball that is cleared out by teenage Katebe. We are in the dying minutes then, the last 10 minutes of this match here at Mandava Stadium, right here in Zishabane, and FC Platinum are still holding on to the 1-0 lead here. As at this time, Katebe has lost that one, although he clears it on the second option, but still coming FC Platinum. This could be an opportunity. Mudewe does well, but Mudaga with a fine save once more for Bantu Rovers. As at this time, they clear it out. They'll pick it this time with Coutinho just by the center circle. To the left this time for Master Mulangeni. Coutinho. Bukosi. Missed. Taken out this time by Kahadzikwa. A through ball this time from Mudewe. And Katebe is in first to clear that one out. Mudewe was on the line. Kwatairo had done well to come up with a shot. A fine turn, but Takunda Mutanga saving the situation. So Cesar Lobuhle today, a veteran of the local premiership, goes in, and going out is Tandazani Ndlovu. It's a midfielder for a striker as they try to get the options, but we are in the last 9 minutes of this match here. Master Mlangeni also going out. In comes Tafata Ngwena in midfield. So it's Mlangeni going out. He was now just playing in front of Sikwili, with Sikwili playing the anchoring role. Proud Zireni in defense. Poor communication between him and goalkeeper on that occasion, maybe costing them. Bantu Rovers, here is Coutinho. Vukosi Sivanda. Vukosi, a tackle will come through from Katebe. It's a free kick which goes to Bantu Rovers. Lots of commitment then from Katebe to keep things tied, and the tackle on the youngster, a free kick to Bantu Rovers. It might be some distance, but Lawson Gomo is also a dead ball specialist. He will try his luck as Petros Muhari just monitors the situation here in the last 8 minutes. It will be Ngomo. It's blocked well by FC Platinum for a throw-in. Ngomo. Bukosi. The cross comes through inside the box. It falls again on Coutinho. Platinum are defending in numbers. Through ball this time, cleared out again by FC Platinum. Just clearing the pieces, but not quite FC Platinum, as Bantu regain possession with Captain Masugu. Coutinho. Sikwi. The through ball is stopped. There is a foul. It's in favor of FC Platinum. Katebe doing the clearing. And it's a free kick to FC Platinum, who are leading this one here by 1-0. As we get into the last 6 minutes of this match, it's going to be a big 6 minutes for FC Platinum to maintain this lead and secure only their fourth win of the season. But it will be a big win, a big 3 points as well. Gatsiko. The clearance from Hadi. Sikwili fails to control. Sikwili clears. Masugu has done well to win that one for Bantu. Coutinho. The cross is out. No danger then for...
Easy! Aubrey! 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 Vira Bora, man! Vira Bora, then you go! Allen! 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 You're up, and also now...
He wants the 3 points. Then, Lloyd Mutasa. In the closing stages, a lot of instructions then from him to his men, just to try and hold on to this lead here. Can they do it? As that one is cleared out again by Bantu Rovers. A point will do for Bantu Rovers, but it looks like it's going to be difficult. Having failed to pick a point away from home, so it's quite a difficult one for Bantu Rovers on the road. Emberton Chuma with the throw-in then for Bantu. Cleared away by FC Chuma. Marufu in a defense this time will clear just to push it out of touch in the last 3 minutes, plus whatever optional time Rugare Kusasa will add. So FC Platinum would want to hold on here. Cleared out emphatically by FC Platinum. Just to ensure that they hold on to the lead here. Nelson Mazwisa, no goal for him. As Mutanga comes up with a long clearance. Masu with a bit of space. Nkoma. It's cleared out by Platinum. The referee waves play on as the Bantu Rovers players appeal for a handling offense. Chuma. Mudewe, we haven't seen his runs on the right. Maybe this could be the run that will do the damage for Bantu Rovers, just to kill it. Mazwisa with a cross. Lots of red jerseys in that box. But Katairo has an opportunity as he finds now Amin. The cross will come inside the box. Chuma just pushes that one out, but the flag was up for offside. Mutanga now will dispatch at the goal kick for Bantu Rovers. Masugu. Cleared away by Gift Bello. Sikwili. Masugu collects the captain in midfield. Chuma. Bantu Rovers. Failure to penetrate is cleared away by FC Platinum. It's cleared out again by Marshall Mudewe. As we are approaching the last minute of this match here at Mandava Stadium. Bantu Rovers with a poor away record, and it's going to be maintained here. FC Platinum a bit inconsistent this season, but a win will do for them. It will give them more confidence ahead of what will be a very difficult 3 weeks for them ahead. They will travel to Ascot to face Chapungu, then have back-to-back clashes with Shabani Mine in Zishabane Derby. So quite a hectic one for FC Platinum, and they just needed this win, having failed to record a win in their last three matches, although they will be happy to stretch their unbeaten run after this match to five matches. Two wins, and in between those two wins, three consecutive draws. Embatonchuk finding now Katebe with the long clearance. Chuma clears out. 3 minutes of optional time. And we are now in optional time here. The 90 is up as Sikwili comes with the clearance for Bantu Rovers. That's a good ball this time for Brechira. He does well to beat one defender, tries to come up with a shot. Mudaga just collecting that one, although it looked like it was going out, but he just wanted to make sure. The shot was a good one, and the goalkeeper just collected that one. It's cleared out again by FC Platinum. Cleared out of danger by FC Platinum as that one is pushed back to goalkeeper Takunda Mutanga. He urges his men to move up front as he dispatches a long one. We're approaching the second minute of the 3 minutes of the optional time. Nkomo with a shot. It's a long one. It's very high. No danger for Petros Mwari. And FC Platinum. So FC Platinum looking forward to do something that has not been coming often for them here, to keep a clean sheet. And it's a boost for them, as it will go with the goal that they scored. It will go with the 3 points. It will go with a poor record away from home for Bantu Rovers, as Petros Muhari dispatches the goal kick. FC Platinum still holding on to the 1-0 lead. Gift Bello, a veteran of the game, will take his time to dispatch the throw-in. Every second, every tick of the clock will do for FC Platinum. Get out by FC Platinum. Here's Sikwili. Wide one this time for Lawson Gomo. A few seconds remain as that one is pushed out. No danger for Katebe as they clear it out, FC Platinum. And they will break as well, maybe just to kill this one as a contest. It's Obrechira. He has done well to come through. Look at Mutanga. He collects that one for Bantu Rovers. And the referee will blow to end the match here as Chira tried to sneak that one in, but Mutanga did well to collect. FC Platinum win this one here by 1-0. Marshall Mudewe, with 2 minutes before the break, with the goal. Coutinho disappointed. He could have got the goal, but it was not to be. FC Platinum then keep only their fourth clean sheet of the season, only their second clean sheet at home here. It's their fourth win of the season. It was not in style. This young man tried to keep his team in the game in the first half. A bit of a poor communication then with Zireni that allowed Marshall Mudewe with the goal. There was a cross then from Amin and the shot coming through. Zireni headed it out. It fell on Mudewe with an open goal. He scored and the fans celebrated it in a fine way. So Bantu Rovers are failing to get it. The final scoreline then here at Mandava Stadium is FC Platinum 1, Bantu Rovers 0. And we will link up with Ephraim Tagu for pitchside interviews.
Yes, I'm joined here by Metemba Ndlovu, the Bantu Rovers coach. Unfortunately, today they walk away with nothing. Final score here, 1-0. Metembe, what's your assessment of the game?
Yeah, I thought we played okay. I'm happy with the guys. I think maybe there's something that we're not getting right, but they gave everything that they had. They played well. It's just we're not getting the rap of the Irish at the moment.
Do you feel you deserved a little bit more out of the game given the way you created chances, especially in the first half?
Yeah, I thought we were on top of the game in the first half. We're not sure about the way the game went, but we don't want to point fingers at anyone. But we thought we should have got something out of this game, but that's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes. We just have to accept it and move on to the next game.
And your record away from home, what's your view on that?
Yeah, I don't want to get into trouble, but I think some of the calls that, I would get into trouble if I'm honest, so I'm just going to keep quiet. But I think everyone who was watching saw how the game was managed today, and I'm proud of my players. I thought they gave everything that they had. I don't want to get into trouble with the league, so I'll reserve my other comments. But I think everyone who was watching saw for themselves.
And perhaps on a positive note, Obadiah Tarumbo again showing a bit of intent up front?
Yeah, no, I think he's come on in leaps and bounds since the beginning of the season. He's one of our best players. Unfortunately, he had to come off with an injury today, but very pleased with what he's contributing to the team.
Thanks for talking to us, Metembe.
Thank you.
That's Metembe Ndlovu, the Bantu Rovers coach. Unfortunately, today they walk away with nothing. And I'm now joined by Lloyd Mtasa, victorious again here at Mandava Stadium. Lloyd, what was key to victory?
Yeah, I think we read the riot act. We played three games, all coming out draws, and probably playing at home. We really needed a win, and we just said, let's go out there and give it a fight. And maybe it might be a turning point for us.
It looked as though you went for youth today, both Wisdom Tasa and Walter Mson are getting starts.
Yeah, if you look at Bantu Rovers, they have youth in their ranks as well. And you know, youth have energy, and probably the youngsters played as well last week, and we gave them a run again this week because we want to try and have a winning formula.
And Nelson Mazibisa, today you gave him an opportunity. What's your verdict on the way he played?
Yeah, I think Nelson played well. He started as well when we played Aumain, and this was his second start coming from Bulawayo, and I think he gave it his all. He was hardworking with and without the ball, and I think it was just unfortunate that he could not come out with a goal.
And talking about hard work and performing well, Marshall Mudewe continues to sparkle for you. Special words for him?
Yeah, I think Marshall he had a quiet game last week, and then we had to take him out during the first period, and we told him that he needs to up his socks again, and he showed us today that he's capable to rise again.
Many congratulations, Lloyd. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
That was Lloyd Mtasa, the FC Platinum coach, yet again getting the result here at Mandava Stadium, courtesy of a Marshall Mudewe strike. So it has ended here at Mandava Stadium. FC Platinum 1, Bantu Rovers 0.
Bongo,